Swagatam, good afternoon, namaskar, and welcome. We begin today's program with Rabta. Rabta is a derivation from the Urdu word for connection. It is strong, and yet inexplicable and mysterious. Some of us identify this connection with home, with our homeland, or with our nostalgic traditions. Today's Rabta elaborates on the connection of the younger generation, whose identities are created by their US environment, but who continue to feel an inexplicable pull towards their heritage, their parents' homeland, or Desh. It is based on a true story and is epitomized through an odyssey of bhava, mudra, and rasa. Today, we narrate the story of Radhika, who is caught between the dichotomy of two cultures, the Western world, where she has been raised, and the strongly embedded value of her parents from Bengal. She embarks on a journey through India and immerses herself in differing cultures in search of her inner self, all the while allowing us to view the moments she captures through her lens. Her journey is full of wonder and yet fraught with conflicting values. She searches for acceptance and the reasons behind it. She questions the quintessential value of respecting elders. She fights her own demons and how her traditional values led her to her own Me Too story at the hands of a trusted uncle. She learns to face her demons, her fears. She stands up not only for herself, but for all girls. And through this all, she embraces her heritage. She finds her own rock. Thank you.
Dugga, Dugga. And you are still daydreaming.
I don't understand this. How can you be so unambitious and lazy at 22?
When I was your age, I used to get up at 6
in the morning and start work by 8 a.m. I know, Ma, you are perfect. Just let me be my imperfect self and be happy with it.
Beshi kotha. Listen, breakfast is ready and it's on the table. Kenyo. Oh, please think about what I told you last night.
Your Dida is very ill.
Think about how happy she would be if you visited her. Please.
There she goes again with her emotional blackmail. How do I tell her that I just had a nightmare about Roy Uncle?
Hey, what's up? Is everything okay? You seem a bit worried.
Oh, well, the usual. My mother really wants me to visit my grandma in Kolkata this summer. But you know how things are over there. And then this would be the only summer I get to spend some time with you before you go back home for your internship.
So why don't you go visit your grandma and then visit me at my home?
Your home?
Yeah.
You mean Senegal?
Yeah, what's wrong with that plan?
Well, I will have to apply to grad school and figure out my life. I don't think I can afford 2 international trips this year.
But going to India might help you build your portfolio, and it will help you build the application for your MFA programs.
That's true. I'll have plenty of opportunities to go around the country, take photographs, and build my portfolio. Actually, Shruti even gave me an open invitation to accompany her for all of her dance festivals this summer. She's going to be performing in quite a few places in India.
There you go.
But you know, the moment I land in Kolkata, there will be 1,000 aunties and uncles asking me all sorts of inappropriate questions. Oh, you're so thin. Why don't you eat a little? Stop dieting. You're 22 and not married yet? How disgraceful. And then there's Roy Uncle. He'll be very polite and nice to you, but I cannot stand him. The very thought of the visit starts to make me uncomfortable. And the worst is when they want to lecture me on whom I should be dating. I think my mom told my grandma about you, and then all hell broke loose.
What did she say?
Well, the usual. It's more like it's a different religion, a different culture. You won't be able to adjust to such changes. You're used to different things. They were brought up differently. They don't do puja. And then there is
what?
Nothing. Let's just forget it. Well, Shruti says it's difficult to change their viewpoints at this age, but I feel if we don't challenge their viewpoints, they will never be open to accepting another.
Yeah, but you haven't finished your thought yet. There is what? You mean my blackness?
You know, there is that. And I think it's not just your blackness. I think it's the usual colonial hangover of wanting to be fair and lovely and wanting to perpetuate that. It's more about colorism than racism for my family. My own sister, who has a darker complexion, has to deal with a lot of bullshit. It's messed up.
Well, I have an idea. Why don't you go visit for your own sake? It will help you care, and you'll have an opportunity to visit different festivals, and you'll be pampered by your grandma, and you'll tell them that was all my idea, and they will be excited. And get us married off, and we'll live happily ever after.
Yes, of course. But you know what's easier? Let's just run away and not give an F.
Yeah, but easier is not always happier. Let's take a difficult route, so that we can pat ourselves in the back and tell our children inspirational stories about how we change the world.
Yeah, you're right. You know, it's just that I have such a love-hate relationship with the city. It's very troubling. Kolkata is my home. It's where I was born and spent the first 5 years of my life. All my cousins, my relatives, the old house in Ramesh Mitra Road, it's all like a dream. And I still have dreams where I see that tiny alley leading up to the house, The parking lot where my brothers played cricket endlessly. The little staircase that led up to the house where my sister and I would play in our make-believe world. Ooh, I can still smell the mutton curry that would be cooked every Sunday. And the summer rain that would fall gently on our green asbestos roof that covered the little courtyard. It was all so magical, Abdu. And yet, all the beauty seems so ugly sometimes with my family's fixed ideas about tradition and modernity. How to be, what to wear, whom to date. It's stifling. Oh, Abdu, it's time for me to meet Shruti. I'll talk to you later. I just woke up, getting coffee. What about you?
I was about to go to bed. I thought I would try.
Yeah, sorry I missed your calls yesterday. We were traveling, the network wasn't so great.
No worries. Where are you at?
I'm in Guwahati.
Where is that?
Assam. Northeastern state. I bought a traditional Mekla chadar from a store here.
What is that?
The traditional attire here.
What? I thought it's called sari.
Well, people wear saris in different parts of India, but there are traditional attires specific to each place as well.
How fascinating. You know, we have a traditional outfit called kepa for men, and they look exactly the same like Indian borders.
Really?
Yeah. Google them. We have much more in common than we know.
Hey, by the way, I'll be documenting an Assamese dance performance tonight. It seems like my photography project is turning out to be an ethnographic research project through photography.
Well, are you enjoying your project?
I am, but I miss home.
You mean your home in the US or home in Kolkata?
It's funny that you ask. Shruti says Kolkata is only about an hour away from Guwahati. And now that I'm here, I am kind of considering visiting my parents after this project. Shruti just wants me to go because she wants to experience Durga Puja in the city. But, you know, I'm not sure. I'm in between doubt, dread, and excitement?
Come on. They are your family. You shouldn't be too terrified.
Oye beli bi huti ho ke sonno ke wana hapupuli ngo wana enna flo kunde mala hoy to bella e ko soko bhangi sa soko
Oh, na sunna lagi bo, na sunna lagi bo, pa.
rich city is. So much history, so much culture. I wish you were here with me. I would show you around.
I'm glad you are enjoying the city, sweetheart. Some days, I do wish I had gone with you. It gets lonely here without you.
I've been doing all the touristy things here. Visited Red Fort, Jama Masjid, Qutub Minar, Jantar Mantar, and Humayun's tomb. Delhi is so beautiful during this time of year. There's a chill in the air during the evenings, and a certain smell that I don't know how to describe. Shruti and I call it the about to fall in love smell. Last night, around 2 a.m., we went to India Gate, walked around, made fun of couples having ice cream, and then we had ice cream. I wish you were here.
Well, don't have so much fun that you don't want to return to me. I'm done with my project here and living for Senegal soon. I'll keep you posted. Give my love to your family. Love you, sweetheart.
Since when do you love my family? By the way, I got something for you. A nice blue kurta. Oh, and we went to the Prandiwali Gully in Old Delhi. You know the prandis there are out of this world. Not like the frozen prandis we get from the Indian stores in Sunnyvale. Next time, you have to come with me to Delhi, even if it's just to taste these parandas.
And smell the about to fall in love smell.
Hi, Shona.
Hey, Mom.
Are you enjoying?
Yeah, it's going great.
Okay, Baba. Now that you are in India, can you not make a trip to Kolkata?
Ma, please don't start again. I'm so tired.
Whenever I want to talk to you, you are tired. You have absolutely no time for me.
Ma, what should I say? I am tired. I've been traveling all day. We just reached Gujarat this morning. Jet lag is catching up.
Okay, Shona. You take some rest tonight. But remember, even though we raised you in America, you are the daughter of Bengali immigrant parents. Do you know how hard it is to uproot your entire family and start from scratch?
Ma, nobody forced you to do that. That was your choice.
Yes, but Radhika, there are certain traditions we expect you to respect and follow.
Not all traditions are respect worthy, Ma.
Listen, you are in Gujarat. If you don't go to Kolkata, it will be very disrespectful to your elders, to your grandma. Khub baje dakhai, Baba.
Ma, I do not care if you baje dakhai. Elders such as royal girls don't evoke any respect in me. Just the sight of him makes me want to throw up.
Baba, why are you so extreme? What did royal uncle do? He's always so nice, so friendly, so generous to everyone.
Ma, it's pointless talking to you. You will never understand.
Acha, just listen to me. Is it too much to ask you to go to Kolkata? Your aunties, your uncles, your dida, they all adore you, Baba. They are your family.
Ma, I don't believe in family that's just handed down to you. I believe in chosen family.
Okay, Shona. Theek ache. Do whatever you think is right. I will never win an argument with you, that's for sure.
Ma, let's just talk later. I'm already late to go document a Gujarati dance, and you're holding me up. Bye.
Bye, Shona. Roy uncle?
Oh,
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Thank you.
Does the Santa dance not remind you of the Bihu dance? They're all so similar.
Exactly. You know, Abhu always says that we have so much more in common than we know or imagine.
Dances and songs, telling stories around the fire. It's as ancient as human civilization itself. We all have the urge to tell stories with our bodies and our minds. These dances are so graceful. It's like the entire universe reflecting synchronicity through rhythm and movement and music.
You sound like a dancer who is high.
Well, dancing does give me a high.
Hey, what do you call these in English again?
Oh, I think they're called kashfu.
Oh, I know how our moms shriek whenever they see these by the side of the highways or just in abandoned fields. You know, surprisingly, they're everywhere in the U.S.
Yeah, but don't you think that they look healthier there than here?
But it smells so different here. You know, it's almost indescribable. How do we describe smells that remind us
of dawn?
You know, how you have that weird connection to the land to which your body belongs? Perhaps we're just organic, like microbes that grow in soil. We just make too much fuss of our huge human egos. But ultimately, we are organic. We are born, we decay, we die. Tell me something, Shuppi. Haven't you been confused having two languages, two cultures, two families, two geographic locations to call your home?
Yes, but over time, I actually embraced this confusion. I sneakily use my Indian side when that is more convenient, but then turn into a complete American when that is more necessary. Do you know what I mean?
I know exactly what you mean. You know, I should definitely start embracing my conflicts instead of resisting them. You know, a wise man once said, we all have so much more in common than we know.
Wise man said? What the heck is this wise man?
Abdu
said.
Yeah,
what was it? Abdu said. Abdu.
Namaste.
बहु फल दे जय शुभ विशुभ कपाल धरे
back to a place that you never left.